was targeted when she was fielded from Basirhat by the TMC in the Lok Sabha elections. She was trolled for wearing jeans and a shirt on her first day to parliament. Now there is another attempt to intimidate TMC MP Nusrat Jahan for her sartorial sense. Hardliners and fundamentalists have issued a fatwa for her personal choices. And as this actor-turned-politician braves it all, those who should have come forward in support have maintained a conspicuous silence. That includes Mamata Banerjee, her leader and the Chief Minister of West Bengal. Here's a report. Take a look.
Dressed in white and red, sporting bangles, vermilion and henna, this first-time MP made quite a statement on her oath-taking in the Lok Sabha.
Ami Nusrat Jahan Ruhi Jain, Lok Sabha Sadasya Nirbachito Hoiya.
But not everyone was impressed by TMC MP Nusrat Jahan's new bride avatar. A section of hardliners was outraged by her so-called un-Islamic sartorial choice.
Islam ye kehta hai ki ek musliman sirf ek musliman se shaadi kar sakta hai kisi gair se nahi iske liye aur dusri baat ye bata dun aapko ki Nusrat Jahan jo hai wo ek actor hain ek filmi usme wo kaam karti hain aur ye jo actor hote hain main samajhta hu ki deen aur dharm inke nazdeek koi haisiyat nahi rakhta.
While one section of the community targeted her, there was another section backing her free will.
Aur Islam itna halka madhab nahi hai ki koi बिंदिया लगा के या अपने सिंदूर लगा के वो निकलता है तो उससे इस्लाम खतरे में पड़ जाता है. इस्लाम को कोई खतरा नहीं है.
इसके बारे में तय करने वाला किसी कोई दूसरा नहीं हो सकता और किसी को ये इख्तियार भी नहीं दिया जा सकता है कि वो किसी की पर्सनल लाइफ में इंटरफेयर करे. नुसरत जहां साहिबा ने संसद के अंदर जो पहना या जो लाइफ स्टाइल इख्तियार किया वो उनका अपना पर्सनल मामला है.
इवन अदर प्रोमिनेंट वॉइसेस केम आउट इन सपोर्ट ऑफ द फर्स्ट टाइम एमपी.
If any religious organization tries to be over and above the constitution, they can't do so, nor can they behave like a court and pass an order on anyone.
This is a very personal matter. Marriage is a very personal matter. Her decision to dress in a particular way is a very personal matter. And I don't see why anybody should be issuing any fatwas, or these kind of fatwas should be not taken seriously at all.
But what was conspicuous was TMC Chief Mamata Banerjee's silence. Just a few weeks ago, West Bengal Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee had rushed to issue a clarification when Nusrat had voiced support for the triple talaq bill. But Didi seems to be turning a blind eye when her party's leader is becoming a soft target for radicals. As Nusrat is forced to fight this battle against bigots all by herself, Mamata's silence begets the question if she's placing appeasement over all else. Your report, Times Now.
You're watching the News Hour Special Edition, Debate Number 2 on Times Now, Super Prime Time.
Binda Adige stays with us on this one as well. Also joining us is Elia Sharfuddin. He's an Islamic scholar, joins us from Hyderabad. Mr. Sharfuddin, my question to you is very simple. Who are these individuals who claim to be the know-all, be-all, end-all of Islamic theology to tell Nusrat Jahan what to wear, what not to wear? Why are they interfering in her personal life? What right do they have to tell anybody, Muslim or non-Muslim, on what they should or shouldn't do in their personal life?
They are teachers. They are teachers of the theology, Quran, Hadith, as well as Vedas, Gita, Upanishad, like me. And we have every right to educate Nusrat Jahan, Zahira Wasim, Shah Rukh Khan, Amir Khan, and everyone throughout the globe, including Modi and Donald Trump, what is good and bad for
no,
them and
who,
their nation
who
and
died
the world.
And made you God?
In the light of the religious scriptures.
Who died and made you God?
That's what we do.
Who died and made you God?
We are not God. We are the servants.
No, then how can you educate anybody? How presumptuous
of
you?
Teachers of the ignorance.
How presumptuous of you, Mr. Sharfuddin, to say that you are here to educate people who might not want anything to do with you?
Will you allow anyone to just fall off the cliff directly by knowing that they are going to die?
Are you the in charge of everybody, every Muslim's life?
From the path of
Mr. Sharfuddin, with all due respect to you. Oh, one second. Mr. Sharfuddin, with all due respect to you and other Islamic theologians or scholars, who made them the caretakers of personal behavior of any Muslim, non-Muslim, whatever the denomination might be? If Nusrat Jahan has married a non-Muslim, it's her prerogative. If she wants to wear a sari, bindi and a sindoor, it's her prerogative. We don't live in Saudi Arabia. This is not an Islamic state. We have a constitution which allows Nusrat Jahan to marry whoever she wants, wear whatever she wants, do whatever she wants.
In front of only God Almighty, there is nothing personal. Everything belongs to Him and He alone controls it and guides everyone.
So then let it be between Nusrat Jahan and God. Why are you coming in the middle?
Light of that, we are guiding them.
No, no, let it be between God and Nusrat Jahan. What is your role here?
We are conveying the message, that's it.
No, let it be between God and Nusrat Jahan. It's her God. What do you want to do in between?
Are bhai, she being an ignorant fellow, she's deviating. Being not
deviating
having,
from
not
what?
The knowledge of the religious
scriptures. No, deviating from what?
Our job is to again guide
deviating
her.
Deviating from what? When she married Mr. Jain, you didn't come up with a fatwa, did you?
By saying Vande Mataram.
No, no, one second. Mr. Sharfuddin, when she married a non-Muslim.
Already we are having Me Too movement.
When she married
India,
a non-Muslim, where were all these fatwas then? Nobody cared. Nobody cared. If only when she tried to display that she had been married to a non-Muslim and carrying on a Hindu tradition by wearing sindoor, did all these clerics have a problem? It's publicity hunting for these clerics, not for Nusrat Jahan, sir.
Yes. Nah, bhai. We are already famous. We need not require more publicity.
No. I'm sorry. That
we
kind
are
of fame,
worldwide.
You know, that kind of fame,
Allah,
I don't think is right. I quickly want to go across to Brinda Adige as well. Brinda Adige, the fact that these individuals, and I'm pretty familiar by now in the process of issuing a fatwa. First of all, a fatwa is not a decree. A fatwa can't be just given. If you go strictly by Islamic theology, if somebody goes to a cleric asking for a particular problem or a particular interpretation, only then can a fatwa be given. And a fatwa is not binding by any chance. Why do these clerics insist on making everything about hardliners, fundamentalism, encroaching on the personal space of individuals who they believe they can educate? I just don't get it.
Because these clerics do not want women to be a person of her own. This woman is to be considered somebody who is not worth. These clerics also do not want to consider this woman to be a citizen who Allah. Can make her own decisions of what she wants to wear, how she wants to wear it, what she wants to eat, and who she wants to marry. These clerics do not have the guts to issue a fatwa against that Maulvi who raped children inside that madrasa. Sexually assaulted some of one of the Maulvis also sexually assaulted some of the children. Why don't they go and issue fatwas over there? If they are teachers, they should be issuing for all of that. Right now, in a country like India, the constitution is supreme. She is an elected representative and she can decide what she wants to wear, who she wants to marry.
And the worst part is,
you teachers do not
part, according to me, according to me is this. The trolls are found everywhere these days. One second, Mr. Ilyas Sharfuddin, give me a second now, please. I want to highlight what others have said today. And other, of course, by others, I mean people who you generally agree with. People like Mr. Oweisi, who's a well-known political leader. He said today, and I quote now when asked about it, he said, "I believe everyone has their right to religious freedom." Unquote. He has no problem with Nusrat Jahan doing whatever she wants. Why should he? He's an educated man. He also happens to be a Muslim. Also happens to be a Muslim of a Muslim majority party. Again, I would like to quote to you a member of the All India Shia Personal Law Board, Mr. Yaqub Yasub. One second. No. Please.
Stop it with
Ilyas ji, please. The reason being given by the Maulvis who have issued this so-called fatwa is that, this is against Islam, etc., etc. Now, this particular person, Yasub Abbas, says Islam has a designated dress code for women. There is no threat to Islam if someone wears a bindi or vermilion. This has got nothing to do with Islam. This is the TMC leader's personal choice. Now, he's also an Islamic theologian. He's also a scholar. He has no problem.
No. Against Quran and the Hadith. Let me quote you the Quranic ayat from chapter 24, verse 31. When the woman go out, cover herself from top to bottom, Allah says, so do the Rigved commands. Book number 10, chapter number 33, verse number 14. When the woman goes, cover yourself
do
completely.
All Muslim women,
and it also
do
commands
all Muslim
Quran
women in this country wear the hijab,
capital punishment to rapists.
No, no, one second. Oh, excuse me, what are you saying? What are you saying, Mr. Ilyas Sharafuddin? Do all Muslim women in India who
yes.
follow their religion but
know.
Do not wear a hijab or cover their heads from, cover
nowadays.
Their bodies from head to toe, are you going to excommunicate them from the religion? Who gave you that right?
No, we are not doing that. We are educating.
Of course,
them.
That's what you're doing.
Usrat is like
that's what you're trying to do.
So do Zahira Wasim, so do Aishwarya Rai.
It's their life, sir.
We are trying to educate
it's their
them.
Life. It's,
them
it's between them and their God.
Their
why are you coming in between?
Choice.
What right do
and
you have to come in between,
want.
Sir?
Because they didn't read the word of God, sir. We are educating them, my dear.
No, I'm sorry, sir. That's highly presumptuous of you to know, to think that you know everything
you
and the others,
and
of course, have no idea
you
about what Islam is. That's highly presumptuous of you. One second. I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Binda DK.
You know, what also has caught the notice of many individuals today is that Nusrat Jahan happens to be from a particular political party, the TMC, the Trinamool Congress, and her own leader, who also happens to be a woman, Mamata Banerjee, has not said a word till now on either the trolls who are trolling her online for wearing bindi and sindoor and etc., or to those who are issuing so-called fatwas against her. Why is it? Why is it that Mamata Banerjee, who can speak and tweet on almost everything, can't even defend her own MP?
Well, she is afraid. She's afraid of the vote bank and she doesn't want to support her own MP. As a woman, she needs to have stood up there and said that this is my MP and she can wear what she wants. She can wear sindoor, she can wear sari, she can wear bindi and she can wear mangalsutra. But she will not do that because she wants the vote of the Muslims, and the Muslim clerics are the one who probably encourage and say that you need to vote for Mamata Banerjee. And that is what we want to ask over here. In a democracy, how do you double speak? Where you say that, you know, all these things are wrong, but I will not stand up for my MP who is a woman and she has a choice, which is an entitlement by the constitution. And these Muslim clerics, I don't talk when you are talking.
No,
why do you interrupt me? As a teacher, is this what you
I'm sorry, sir. I'm sorry. By linking how a woman dresses. By linking how a woman dresses to threats to her person and threats like rape, I'm sorry, you're not doing anyone any justice. You are displaying a medieval anti-women mindset, sir. It's not just you.
You don't worry about all that. You be worried over here.
Okay, one second. I have last minute on the show. Let me ask you a basic question, sir. Let me ask you a basic question. Do you believe, Mr. Ilyas Sharafuddin, that India is and should be a democracy which is governed by rule of law and the constitution, yes or no?
Law has been changed 100 times, our constitution got amended.
No,
let us amend it again and bring the law of God Almighty and protect all Indian daughters from rapes, feticide, murders.
The Indian daughters can protect themselves with a little bit of help from the state. They don't need clerics, either Hindu clerics or Muslim clerics. And I have no kind words for those also either. And if you believe, Mr. Sharafuddin, if you believe that I'm only singling out these Muslim clerics today who have come out with this ridiculous fatwa or so-called fatwa, you are wrong, because they're as bad as those Hindu hardliners who make it an issue every time a Hindu woman is seen with a Muslim boy. They're worse than this, but they're part of the same boat. They're no better. But my point here is, any woman in this country, any man in this country, is free to do what they choose to do, free to do what they want, marry whoever they want, wear what they want, and clerics, either in the Muslim community or hardliners in the Hindu community, need to understand this and understand this quickly. You cannot carry out this sharad for very long. You will not be able to sway the millions and millions of young people today who do not care about your hardline radical interpretation of various religions. Binda Adige, last word to you. How should Nusrat actually handle this? I believe she's handled it already. But how do you think is the best way to respond to these clerics, these trolls, or who are these haters are who are targeting Nusrat Jahan?
Ignore him. Ignore.
Best way is to accept the truth. That's it.
All right, ignore them. Ignore them. But still, we would like to see Mamata Banerjee, who is a woman herself, happens to be a woman herself, and the leader of the party that Nusrat Jahan belongs to, come out and condemn these individuals for what they are doing, trying to intimidate an elected member of parliament, a young member of parliament, who perhaps will go on, hopefully, to do great things for her state, for her people, and for her country. Her personal choices are personal choices. Clerics really can keep what they think their interpretations are to themselves. Nusrat Jahan does not need any help. If you believe she's doing something wrong in the eyes of God, well, it's between her and her God. No need to get between the two. Thank you for joining us, Ilya Sharfuddin and Brinda Arige. We'll take a short, very quick break now.
The News Hour Special Edition.